children, welcome to our English lesson. Our lesson today focuses on Unit 9 of your Grade 10 textbook. This is the last lesson you are going to study for Unit 9. Today let's learn how to use prepositions appropriately. Let's start the lesson. Children, I have done 2 lessons on prepositions. One is prepositions of place, and it is the second lesson in Unit 2. Next, you did another lesson on prepositions of time, which is Unit 6, Lesson 5. So if you have missed them, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and watch them. Today we are going to learn some more prepositions of time and prepositions of direction. Okay, let's recap what prepositions are. A preposition is a word used to link nouns, pronouns, or phrases to other words within a sentence. Prepositions help to connect the people, objects, time, and locations within a sentence. Prepositions are usually short words, and they are normally placed directly in front of nouns or pronouns. Let's look at this example. Here, the preposition under is used to link the two nouns cat and table, showing the location or the place of the cat. Under is a preposition of place. Now look at this example. Here, the preposition since is used to link the noun Nizam and the noun phrase 3 o'clock, showing a time relationship. Since is a preposition of time. Prepositions of time are used to indicate time of an action or time relationship within a sentence. As you have already learned some prepositions of time, today I am focusing on these 3 prepositions of time only: since, till, and until. First, let's learn about since. Let's look at the example we saw earlier once again. Nizam has been waiting since 3 o'clock. So Nizam is the noun, has been waiting is the verb, since is the preposition, and 3 o'clock is the noun phrase. Children, we use since to refer back to a previous point in time. We use since as a preposition with a date, a time, or a noun phrase referring to a point of time. It was my first trip to Katharagama since December 2018. Here you have since and a date. I have been learning English for 8 years since grade 3. Here you have since and a noun phrase referring to a previous point of time. Now let's learn about the 2 prepositions of time, till and until. They can be used both as prepositions and conjunctions, but today we are learning only about their function as prepositions. The 2 prepositions until and till indicate when something will happen, begin, or end. They are used as prepositions of time only. Children, these 2 prepositions until and till mean exactly the same. But till is more common in informal style. Look at these 2 examples. Sumudu waited until 6 o'clock and then went home. Or you can say Sumudu waited till 6 o'clock and then went home. Okay, next we'll have a look at the 3 prepositions towards, around, and off. These 3 prepositions belong to the prepositions of direction. They are also called prepositions of movement. Prepositions of direction show direction or movement from one place to another place. Let's look at these examples. They could see the river clearly as they walked towards it. They walked around the park to reach the library. The bottle fell off the table and shattered on the floor. In each of these examples, you can see how the direction or the movement is indicated with the help of the preposition. Now let's see the meanings of each of these three prepositions. First we'll take towards. Towards means movement in the direction of something. Then around. Around means movement passing something in a curved route, not going through it. And then off. Off means movement away from and often down from something. This image will graphically show you the prepositions of direction clearly. I hope you are clear about the six prepositions we learned today. Okay children, let's do some practice activities on prepositions. As you have learned prepositions of time, place and direction, let's do these activities to revise all of them. First we'll do activity 11 on page 100 of your textbook. This is the activity. You have to fill in the blanks with a suitable preposition from those given within brackets. Okay, pause the video and do it now. Let's see how you have done it. Read the first sentence. I walked blank and within brackets you have towards and off the building looking for the entrance. Now, do you remember the meaning of the two prepositions towards and off? Towards mean the movement in the direction of something, and off means movement away and often down from something. So which one out of the two is suitable to fill the blank? To look for the entrance of the building, you can't walk away from it. You have to walk towards the building. So the answer is towards. I walked towards the building looking for the entrance. Now the second one. You have to do revision exercises, blank, and within brackets you have since and until next month. As I taught you earlier, we use since to refer back to a previous point in time. The preposition until is used to indicate when something will happen, begin or end. This sentence doesn't refer to an action at a previous point of time. It tells us about the end of revision exercises. So the answer is until. You have to do revision exercises until next month. Let's read the third one now. The farmers will make the land ready, blank, within brackets you have till and off, they get rain. This one is not very difficult now because from the two answers, one is a preposition of time and the other one is a preposition of direction. It is clear that you need a preposition of time in this situation. So you have to select till. The farmers will make the land ready till they get rain. Now look at the fourth one. You have to get blank, off, round, the bus at the junction and walk to the school. Okay, not very difficult. You have to get off the bus at the junction and walk to the school. Now the last one. We have been learning English, blank, and within brackets you have till and since. We were in grade 3. Here we were in grade 3 refers to a previous point in time. So you have to fill the blank with since. We have been learning English since we were in grade 3. I hope you could get all the answers correct. Now let's do another activity. This is activity 12 on page 100 of your textbook. I have made a slight change to the activity given. You have a paragraph with blanks here. This time also you have to fill in each blank in the paragraph with a suitable preposition from the given list. You have 5 blanks, but there are only 4 answers. That means you can use the same answer twice. Pause the video and do it now. Now let's see how you have done it. Let's read the completed paragraph. Selvan walked towards the room, feeling a little bit excited. It was his first job interview. He did not want to apply for any job until this year. He had been following a computer course since 2016. Now that it is over, he is ready to do a job. He waited until the interviewers asked him to sit down and then he thanked them. Then he looked around the room. He felt relaxed when the interviewers asked him to talk about himself. So you have to use the preposition of time until twice in the paragraph. Hope you got all the answers correct. Okay, now let's attempt a question from a past paper. This is a question from 2018 O-level paper. In this activity, you have a dialogue with blanks. You have to fill in the blanks with the correct answers from the given list. The answers are all prepositions belonging to different types. You can pause the video and do it now. Let's check your answers now. I will read the completed dialogue. The dialogue is between a policeman and an eyewitness of a road accident. Where were you exactly when the accident happened? I was inside the school bus. Did you clearly see what happened? Yes, a motorbike was coming behind our bus. The driver stopped the bus because of heavy traffic. After that, the motorbike tried to overtake us and collided with a van coming from the opposite direction. When did this happen? I think it was around 7 a.m. Thank you for the information. You're welcome. Okay, children, I hope it was easy and you got all correct. Okay, children. Now we have come to the end of today's lesson on prepositions. In this lesson, we learned how to use prepositions appropriately. We mainly focused on 6 prepositions today. 3 prepositions of time and 3 prepositions of direction. I hope it was useful to you. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Goodbye.